the United States entered World War II with a military that was segregated by race and remained segregated until 1948. In 1941, the War Department and the Army Air Corps formed the first all-black flying unit, the 99th Pursuit Squadron. 11 white officers were chosen to teach the 429 black enlisted airmen and 47 black officers at the Tuskegee Institute in Tuskegee, Alabama. The budding flight program received a publicity boost when First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt inspected it in March 1941. The First Lady flew with African-American Chief Civilian Instructor Charles Alfred Anderson. The 99th was considered ready for combat duty by April 1943 and shipped out of Tuskegee on April 2nd. They were bound for North Africa, and later Sicily and elsewhere in Italy, flying sorties and escort missions for 2 years. The 99th's first combat mission was to participate in the attack on Pantelleria, a strategic island in the Mediterranean Sea. Codenamed Operation Corkscrew, the mission was to clear sea lanes for the Allied invasion of Sicily in July 1943. The surrender of the garrison of 11,121 Italians and 78 Germans due to air attack was the first of its kind. The Army activated three more squadrons, joined in 1944 by the 99th, that constituted the 332nd Fighter Group. In all, 996 pilots graduated from training at the Tuskegee Airfield, and they flew 1,578 missions and 15,533 sorties. They destroyed 261 enemy aircraft, damaged another 148, and earned more than 850 medals. The 332nd Fighter Group pilots painted the tails of their P-47s red, leading to the nickname Red Tails. Other markings associated with the Tuskegee Airmen included red bands on the noses of their P-51s and a red rudder. Of the pilots who trained in Tuskegee from 1941 to 1946, 352 deployed overseas and 66 were killed in action. Pilots of the 332nd Fighter Group earned 96 Distinguished Flying Crosses, 3 Distinguished Unit Citations, 14 Bronze Stars, 744 Air Medals, and 8 Purple Hearts, among other awards. On March 29, 2007, the Tuskegee Airmen were collectively awarded a Congressional Gold Medal. Many Tuskegee Airmen went on to lead lengthy military careers, and 4 rose to the rank of General. Today, the Red Tails lineage lives on in the 332nd Air Expeditionary Wing, which deployed in Operation Iraqi Freedom.